Hello everybody, my name is Julien Pastor and today I am with Miles and we will talk about identification but also typing, right?
Correct.
Let's go.
You don't want to go for a ride, do you? We could get out of the palace, see the world.
Is it safe?
Sure, do you trust me?
So in a quick overview, like what we talked about with the MALDI Biotyper in terms of the workflow, what we're looking at is we're taking an isolate, we're taking that, we're going direct transfer to a culture plate into our target plate, and then we're running it in the MALDI Biotyper. So the workflow on now our IR Biotyper is very similar.
So the new product name is?
The IR Biotyper, okay. So infrared.
Okay.
Is the method we are now currently using for the strain typing. The difference here is that we're actually now strain typing off of polysaccharide and not the proteins like we were with the MALDI Biotyper.
Okay.
So at this point, we are now able to strain type specifically. You could build your own library with the confirmations or identifications you have already gotten with the MALDI Biotyper.
Okay.
And you are able to build an internal library to understand exactly where those strains may be coming from or if they're similar or the same to what you're already handling.
Okay, so I can know now the source of my strains, of my contamination.
Exactly.
Okay.
So a good example would be if you're running testing for environmental monitoring in your facility and you have identified a specific listeria hit in your facility, you can now add that to the strain typer and then say 2 weeks later you also identify another strain of listeria. You can tell if that's a transient or resident strain at that point through using the IR Biotyper. And then additionally, we have the good bug side. So now we're looking at it as actually strain typing kind of the technological strains that we might need. It's very valuable in a fermentation facility.
Probiotics, things like that.
Exactly. Okay. Probiotics, it'd be a fantastic application there as well.
Okay.
Yes.
Is it as easy as the MALDI Biotyper? It's always the same thing with a target?
Yes. You take an isolate, same thing.
Okay.
You're applying it directly to the target plates, and then at this point, you are then running it through the IR. In terms of strain typing, it's not as fast as the MALDI Biotyper,
okay,
but we're still strain typing within 3 hours.
3 hours?
3 hours.
Still okay.
Yeah.
Okay. About typing, what's about the DNA typing? I mean, this kind of system, the AR system, is really competing directly with this kind of other technology. What's your strengths?
No, we would say specifically kind of the market we're trying to fill is a step between confirmation and whole genome sequencing.
Mm-hmm.
It's much faster.
Okay.
And it isn't going all the way to the whole genome level.
Okay.
So specifically, it's more for an internal, an extra tool in the tool belt that you can actually use in your facility.
6 months ago, we talked about a MALDI Biotyper.
Yes.
Now we are talking about AR. What's happening in 6 months? There is any news coming? Or?
Well, coming soon. We can't talk too much yet, but we're moving towards the lipid testing via lipid profile instead of, now we have protein, polysaccharide, and then we're going to be moving to the lipid section as well.
Wow.
Yeah.
So I hope that I will have some update about that quickly.
We will talk then. Yes, absolutely.
And thank you very much, Miles, for all this information. If you have any question for him or for me, please leave your comment below this video. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye.
All right.
Merci.